Hi guys, welcome to one more video from Optionables. I'm Sujit and in today's video we'll be learning more about algorithmic trading. So we'll be learning it from an experienced trader. So we'll be having an interview with one more experienced fellow trader who's been trading actively in the market for past 5 to 6 years, and in past 2 to 3 years has been consistently making money. So today we are gonna have a discussion or an interview with Mr. Ashit Patel. So he has been a CA finalist and he's been working with one of the major prop desk in India. So he's been doing algorithmic trading consistently and he's been able to come out to be profitable trader. So we have verified that, and we'll be moving on to that, and we'll be understanding how he started, what was his journey, and what are we gonna do with the algorithmic trading, and how do we do it, and is it really worth doing all those things, and we'll be learning more about it from him.
Yeah, thank you Sujit for such a warm welcome.
Yes sir.
It's my pleasure to have a first face-to-face video with you guys actually. And as you asked for the journey, so journey was very much interesting. So as you told, I'm CA finalist. So for CA, you have to go compulsory through the internship, right?
Okay.
So I was doing internship. Besides my principal's office, CA office, there was another office called, some broker's office. I can't name that guy, but anyways, there was some broker's office. So I used to visit that place more and often. So from there only I came to know about this, financial markets, like how trading works, how investing works, how derivative products works. Mm-hmm. So basically I started doing trading without having any knowledge basically, and earned some 20,000-30,000 rupees from there. But as obviously market gets punished if you don't know. So I have lost heavily on one single day whatsoever I have earned, and more on that, I will lose my around, I can say, all the capital, around 80 to 90% of the capital wiped out in one single day.
What was your capital back then?
At that time my capital was around 3 lakhs, so I lost around 2.5 lakhs rupees.
Okay.
So after that, I realized that I lost the money, and what can be done next? So I was looking on the Google, like what can be done. So I came to know about some guys who providing tips, who claim that we are expert and providing some tips. So I lose some another money there. So by this way, I've blown up my accounts for the 2 times. And after that, I realized I have to learn. And I can, earn from the market. So I started learning. I learned price action, some technical indicators and all this thing. And that do sometimes work, there's sometimes don't work, as you guys know. So I realized soon that it's not going to work anyway. So anyway, I started learning the options, and from there only, I'm now consistently profitable since at least last 3 years, 3.5 years actually. So this is how my journey has been started. And
That's great. Like I think all the trader, fellow traders who start on some tips, basically some tips. So we have all seen those people who gives us tips. So start our journey there and we lose money. Then we try to learn something. I think that summarizes every trader's journey. I think So now we'll be moving on. I'll be asking you a few questions about how you trade, so you can give our audience more insights about it.
Okay, Sujit. So first of all, let's start with what is the algo trading. So basically, algo trading is trading by bot with predefined set of rules rather than trading manually. So manually, all the guys knows, but bot is quite new for many guys. So it's kind of set of predefined rules, and there can be a two type of algo tradings. First is a fully automated and second is semi-automated. So in fully automated trading bot, what you have to predefine is you have to predefine entry rules, you have to predefine exit rules, you have to predefine adjustment rules. Capital allocation is also you have to predefine so that you can do your risk management very well.
Okay. So why do we have to go with algo? Because we have seen some other issue with that. So as a trader, why do you feel that algo trading
is much better than any other form of trading, discretionary trading or something like that.
Yes. So let's go to the why algo trading slide, where we have covered traditional versus algo trading. So if you see in traditionally, it took around 1 to 3 seconds because you have to execute trade that manually, right?
Okay.
But in algo, yes, you predefine the rules for the entry, exit, stop loss, target, everything is predefined. So it will take around 10 microsecond to 50 microsecond. And some of the algos, if you see, they provide functions of auto delta neutral, where, for example, if you are a delta neutral trader, for example, you are doing straddles and strangles. These are the strategies which have built-in delta neutral strategy. So this is the auto delta neutral. So after market gets moves up or down significantly, then you need to adjust positions, right?
Okay.
So some of the algos available, they what they do is automatically neutralize the delta.
Okay.
So you don't have to sit in front of the screen and neutralize your delta. They will automatically neutralize your delta through one or there are many methods. You can neutralize by selling or more options. You can do it by buying options, and you can do it by help of future as well.
Okay.
So first of all, we have talked about the auto delta neutral function. Second is the combined entry. So in combined entry, what it will be doing is, for example, currently straddle is running at, for example, 200 rupees.
Okay.
And you want to short it only if it goes to the 210 level.
Okay.
So what will this software will do is, if it will continuously tracking the price of straddle, for example, call and put, and it will continuously checking that whether it has been reached at the 210 level. Only it will execute the trade only if it reaches to the level of 210. So this is the, in manual trading, it's not possible because you can't continuously check, and obviously it's not possible at manual level. So combined entry is possible. Combined SL and combined target is also possible. So for example, you have taken entry at 210 and now you know you have done short straddle. So for example, it goes to the 250 level, then you want to exit all call and put. You want to exit from call as well as you want to exit from the put. So that is also possible through the algo. So this is the how combined entry and combined SL works. Second thing is minimize slippage, because you are doing trade manually. You need not to find strikes and then execute orders. Software inbuilt has that function to find out the strikes and then execute the trade. So obviously slippage will be the minimal and execution would be fast.
Okay.
And yes.
Oh yeah. You were telling about order slicing. How does it work there?
Yeah, actually, when you are operating with the higher level, so obviously you will be having some 50 or at least 50 to 100 lots, right? So at that point of time, it matters very much that how much order slicing you are doing. If you are doing some, let's say, market order, then obviously there will be huge slippages. So order slicing becomes very important part when you are trading with some 50 to 100 lots. So what algo will do it? It will not make immediately or market order or limit order. What it will do is, it will start trading with some, for example, 5 lots, 10 lots. Again, it will do some 5 lots, 10 lots. By that way, within 1 or 1.5 minutes, it will get all of your order done. So okay. This is how order slicing work.
Okay. So this is how actually every algo works, right? So what happens about the risk management part, we learned about the combined stop loss. So there will be errors with that also. So how do you track out or how do you manage with the algo?
Yes. So as we have seen, this is the sum of the pros that we algo have, but there are some cons also that algo has. For example, let me show you another screen. These are the cons of algo trading, where you continuously need to supervise, because need to have continuous supervision, because this is the algo, not the human. So algo can even be doing some mistakes sometimes, in especially in terms of volatile market, where by any chance one leg has not been executed. So this kind of thing can be there, so you continuously have to supervision. Second thing is inability to take the decisions. So sometimes market gets very volatile, and big protest and other guys has does the SL hunting. So in that kind of irrational market, obviously algo won't work properly as it should work. So this is the second cons of the algo. And third thing is low accessibility, because not all the people are aware about it. Only people who is doing on the exponentially good level only have access to the algo because of certain restriction from the SEBI side.
Okay. Okay. So that is the cons of algo trading. So how do you, what do you do with when there is some other risk involved? Because when we tell that it doesn't have decision-taking capacity, and sometimes when our orders doesn't execute it, get executes on the algo part. So how do you manage it sometimes? Because you would have faced the situation, right?
Yes. So many times what happens is in case of volatile market, what sometime algo does is he has executed the first part, but sometimes not executed the second part. So for example, you want to sell the straddle where call has been sold, but put has not been sold. So for that, we are using some, you know, good level of algo so that this mistake rarely happens. And it's very kind of rare thing which happens. And even if it happens, we are in front of the screen. So what we'll do is we'll manually doing the selling of put.
You will be manually doing. So that's the reason Yes. You said that we need constant supervision.
Yes, yes, yes. And another thing also I have to see that if you are doing it manually, then obviously the all position need to square up manually itself. So these are the things which you have to be cautious when you are using algo.
Okay. So can normal retailers like us who has capital of around 2 lakh start with the algo trading, or is there any softwares for that? Because most of us sometimes won't have time to place orders, right? So we need some other system to be taken care of. So is there any system like that?
First of all, what we can do for this thing is we can do, for example, you can code your own bot. For example, you are not the developer, you don't know how to do the coding, then there are some other people who do coding in behalf of you and will provide the whole bot to the you. But disadvantage of this thing is you have to, you know, check all the each and everything into the detail, and SEBI has n number of restriction for the you know, algo trading. So this is the first case where you have to develop your own bot. Second thing is you can take your ready-made bots. So okay. As I was told you, there are two type of mainly bots available. One is fully automated, second is semi-automated. So we are using semi-automated bot, because in fully automated bot we are not comfortable with. So I can say about the semi-automated bot. So fully automated bot is kind of you know, thing where you cannot do much about this thing, because I've seen many times a person relying totally on the fully automated bot, and aftermarket as gets over, he get free, and I just seen that bot has not executed the, you know, that bot has not closed the trade, and that trade is still open, and you are not carry forwarding it over the night. So basically, sometimes this thing also happens. So we prefer semi-automated bots currently.
Okay.
And basically the bot we are using, algo we are using is called HFT. HFT stands for the high frequency trading, where trading execution time is in the microseconds.
So HFT is the same thing wherein wherein normal public won't be able to get access, right? Like me and you.
Yes. Yes. Won't
be able to get the access. So what is the advantage of this?
HFT is, as I have told you, Sujit, not available for the normal public. It's available only for the people who do at the pro level, pro desk level.
Okay. So this is to get access of it, there is you have to pay a little bit of more for this. How does it work? Basically, how does it work?
Yeah, actually, so HFT stands for the high frequency trading. So many people have misconception about HFT is that if you are having HFT algo, then it will always make the money. But let me tell you, it is not the case. HFT stands for the high frequency trading, where your order will get executed very faster than the normal trading bot or normal manually trading. So high frequency trading only means it will give you the lowest latency possible.
Okay.
And
there is nothing other than that, right?
Yeah, nothing other than that. you have just lowest latency, as I told you. So trading member can place their servers in the exchange data center where they get fastest access to the price feed. So NSC allows this thing, and I will show you further in the further slide that how it will actually works. And colocation facility by NSC, it has been launched in the year of 2000. So derivative contracts has been launched in the year of 2000, but NSC has launched colocation facility in the year of 2009.
Okay.
So how actually it works?
So when we tell of colocation, we have heard that colocation scam, right?
Yes.
Of NSC. So yes. Doesn't this bother us? Because they were giving out a colocation for the highest bidders. So how are we safe on this part? Is it is the system now better, or is the all those things are not there in the system now, or how are we going out with the HFT for the colocation?
Yeah, so in NSC colocation scam, what was happened was some of the brokers getting some fastest data speed. So for that, SEBI has penalized the NSC, and now things are very transparent, very better, unlike earlier. So for example, you are sitting in the colocation. So obviously you are getting the same speed, same latency, same data that all the other colocation players have. NSC, for example, there are kind of level four data. So currently, if you are trading through any broker, for example, let's take an example of normal broker, which all the knows Zerodha, right?
Correct.
So Zerodha using level three data, but
market 20 depth, and it's a level three data.
Yes. So currently, as per my knowledge, there are only two brokers who provide level three data. One is the Zerodha, and second is the Firebase, if I'm not wrong.
Okay.
So all the other guys provides level two data, but if you are using colocation facility, then it is level four data, which is called tick by tick data. So which is the highest possible data that you can take. So if you are using level four data, obviously there will be the low latency, and all the level four data players get the same data on the same time, and there is nothing to worry about it right now.
Okay. So how good is this? Like, because since we don't get the level four data, so who can access to this data? To whom does NSC provide all this level four data and all these things?
Level four data has been provided to some of the specific brokers who meet certain criteria. So okay. For that specifically, normally Prodesk uses this data. So as I'm working through the Prodesk, because that's why I'm getting level four data.
Okay. So normal public like me and other people, we won't be able to get the level four data. So it costs us more. So
yeah,
only at the proprietary level. Okay.
Yes.
Only in the proprietary level and higher level, wherein they have specialized tech teams with them. So they'll be able to get it. Okay.
Yes.
So
yes.
If anyone like you, like, because since we don't have any backgrounds of trading, so if anyone like us have to join any other prop desk or any other big institutions, or how did you go through those process?
Yes, actually, for example, if anyone wants to join the prop desk, then there are the certain criteria that I have written here. So first of all, one should be having minimum 5 year experience trading in the market.
Okay.
Second is he should be profitable for at least 2 years. Last 2 years, and
so last 2 years they should be net profitable.
Yes, and drawdown, we focus very much on the drawdown, so it should be more than 30%. 30% also I have written on the higher side. 30% is very much not acceptable at all.
So maximum is 30%. What you like drawdowns, all this you have to keep track of it in your trading style, and maximum like qualification for you to qualify, you need to have somewhere and maximum you can go up to 30%, but 30% is not that much. So they focus mainly on the risk management part. Okay.
Yes. Whether you are making money or not, it will be depend on the how much drawdown you are making.
Okay. I think I got to know, like for all of them watching out there, like it's not about the money what we make when we start to handle higher funds. So it's all about the drawdown. So how much risk you are taking and how well you are managing the risk. So because going forward, there won't be any person who will ask you to make so much of money, because 15 to 20% per year is more than sufficient. Everyone will focus on the risk part. How much is risk involved? How much are you willing to lose? Then what is the discipline you are putting it out there? And how well you are taking care of your funds, how well you are taking care of your risk. So I think that's the whole idea about the qualifying for the prop desk, right?
Yes, definitely. So as I told you, drawdown is the very important part where we focus more. Fourth thing is personal interview will be taken, where some behavioral aspect and some other scrutinies will be done. Okay. And the fifth thing is NISM certification is needed. It is as per the SEBI's guideline, where if anyone wants to use the HFT platform, then he has to clear the NISM exam, equity derivative exam.
Okay.
And then only he can use the HFT. If let's say he wants to join the prop desk but don't want to use the HFT platform, he wants to do the manual trading using let's say NEST or any other simple platform, then obviously NISM is not required at all.
Okay. But NISM is always preferred, right?
So NISM, yes, yeah. Preferable, because it gives us clarification that you are very well adverse with this thing. You actually knowing this equity derivative segment. So
you have this NISM certificate.
Yes, this is my certification which I have cleared in, as you can see.
Okay, can you just give our viewers just about how to take this exam so that they'll be able to clear it and they'll be able to understand what is the process better?
Yes, actually there is one site called NISM where you will log in. First of all, you have to sign up. You have to filter all the details. You have to upload proof of your resident and one PAN card. Once you done with that, within 2 to 3 days, they will approve your profile. Once your profile has been approved, you can give any of the exams. There are n number of exams available there. So for let's say you want to give for equity derivative exam, then you have to select that particular module.
Okay.
Now you have two options. You can either go to the center, particular center, which NISM might be having around you. And second is, due to COVID, this facility has been launched called online examinations.
Okay.
So you can give examination from your home as well.
Okay.
So as you can see, I have given it on the date of 21 August 2018. My center was Bhavnagar, because I am living in the Bhavnagar, Gujarat itself. And at that time, online examination was not possible. Online just recently launched after this COVID situation.
Okay.
And this is the passing percentage. And
so what is the qualification needed for to pass NISM? Is there any prerequisites or qualification, like you should be 12th pass or you should have a degree or anything like that?
No, actually it doesn't require any pre-qualification.
Okay, anyone can take it, are you sure about that?
Yes, whether you are from science background, commerce background, or maybe from arts background, it doesn't matter. You just can give exam, you can register and you can give exam. For passing, there is a criteria of 60%. So minimum 60% you should be
able to get passed. Okay.
Yes, and there is a negative marking system as well. So each and every one question, on each and every one wrong question, you will be minus, you will be getting minus 0.25.
Okay, perfect. So I think our viewers got to know how they have to go about with the NISM also. Because this is one of the certifications, it's good to have this. Even we are planning to take this up, because this gives us much more knowledge and much more information about how system works, about the risk management, all those things in much better way. So even we are planning to take it. I think you have explained it very nicely and very easily. So I think that's great. So let me just ask you one quick question. So how does this HFT work? Is there any specific thing NSE gives, or how does it work actually?
Yes. So for that, I have taken source from the NSE, as you can see. And it is taken from the NSE site itself, where NSE has mentioned that for institutional clients and other sophisticated traders, NSE provides support for algorithmic trading through co-location facilities. So consisting of rented rec space for servers inside the Exchange premises. I will explain more it in the next slide. So NSE also permits third party vendor to sublease co-location facilities from trading members to provide a wider class of investor with access to co-location service. So basically what NSE does is, for example, let me go to the next slide where I've taken the snap of NSE premises. This is the NSE premises basically, right? And as you can see, for example, this is the space where NSE provides the, NSE has set the primary servers, and this is the space where NSE put in the co-location racks. So what, how you actually get the access is, first of all, they will connect this server with this server through fiber optical cables. So fiber optical cables, as you might know, Jio is also using this fiber optical cables to provide the fastest data possible. So currently this is the technology through which you can transmit data very, very, very fastly. So through this thing, your co-location server will be connected to the primary servers. And by this way, you are getting the lowest latency possible.
Okay.
Because the servers are sitting next, you know, next to the primary servers.
Okay. So HFT basically works like this. So NSE allots a certain set of servers to each and every prop desk or institutional level people. So that's yes. How we get.
Yes.
Okay. Exactly. I think that's a great information what we got. So I'll have one more last question. So yes. Apart from all this, why did you choose algo trading? Like, because you could have done something else. Why did you choose to become a trader, or why did you choose to become an algo trader?
Yes, because see, we are using that software where combined entry and combined SL and combined target is possible, right?
Okay.
So what we does is normally we take entry around 9:30 to 9:45.
Okay.
And then after, as you know, market keeps in the range bounding in 80% of the cases, right?
Okay.
So normally we do certain strategies which has delta neutral and theta positive.
Okay.
And we put in combined SL there. So 80% of the time we don't have to do nothing. We don't have to do anything.
Okay.
So we just put combined SL and combined target. So in 80% of the case, it will be target will be get hitted, and rest 20% of the case we will be managing through algo. So with algo, it's quite very, very, very peaceful. For example, you have combined SL in the system. So even if you close the system and if you go for the, let's say some work for half an hour or maybe 1 hour. So algo with the platform we are using is very much reliable. HFT algo we are using is very much reliable. I am using it since at least 9 months, you can say. So before that I used to use some another algo, but later on I find out this algo where we are having some certain requirements. So this algo was fulfilling our requirements. So
okay.
This
so
is the
I think that's great. Yeah.
Yeah, actually peace of mind you will get it, you know, because you don't have to sit in front of the algo for all the time. If you are using the reliable algo, then only it is possible.
So you are managing, basically your risk is also managed, I think.
Yeah, because if
so whatever strategies you do, you will have your hedging hedge positions, right?
Yeah, actually we hedge it, but not all the time. It depends on the market scenario. But for example, market is very volatile and market is getting trending, then in that case, obviously we are hedging our 40 to 50% of the positions.
40 to 50%. So for our family, what do you suggest to do? Like, how do you tell to manage the risk for them, and what trading style do you ask them to follow, or is there any suggestions for them?
Yes, actually, normally I have tried so many things. I have tried so many indicators, price action, so many things, but nothing well worked well. So finally, I decided to move on to the system where systematic approach can be followed. Okay. So I have tested certain strategies like you guys doing straddles and strangles. So obviously these are the fundamental things that have to work, because as I told you, NSE has launched derivatives contracts in the year of 2000, right?
Correct.
So since 2000, it is 2021 currently running. So in middle of this 21 years, one single thing would always work. This is the straddle and strangle, because this is the fundamental thing where on the expiry day, NS options have to be zero, whether it's a strangle or whether it's a straddle.
Okay, out of money options basically.
Yeah, OTM's options basically going to be zero. So basically, this is the fundamental thing. So we are, have some developed the systems where we are using this fundamental thing. So first of all, I would suggest develop the, some strategy which fundamentally working. It's not like discretionary type of thing. Discretionary thing is also working, but it's more of art thing. If you will show one particular chart of any one particular indicator to the 10 people, then I'm sure 10 people would be having some 10 different opinion on that, right?
Definitely.
So this is a like kind of more of art thing, but we are using science thing where you can have set of rules for the entry, set of rule for the adjustment, set of rule for the exit. So obviously once you have pre-planned, then obviously you will be very much comfortable trading. And you know this thing working in the past, if anything working past for the 21 years, then obviously it will work for the next 21 years as well.
So that it we can't guarantee that it will work, but there are higher chances that it will.
Yes, definitely. It is a fundamental thing, Sujit, actually. So it, as per me, actually, it will work definitely, because on the expiry day, obviously, option gonna be zero if it's our OTMs.
Okay.
So, yes.
So I think we have heard a lot of stories about this. I think it was a great session having you on board. Everything we have covered. So starting from what is algo, so how do we do, what are the requirements which are needed, then what are the pros and cons of algo, then how does HFT work, so how does NSE provide HFT. So we have covered these topics. I think it's a great session for all our family members. So I think that's it for today. So thanks for joining in.
One more point I would like to say, many people would be interesting to see the HFT platform. So okay, we'll be posting one more video after the recording this session.
Okay.
So we'll be showing how actually we are placing the orders, where we'll okay. take some basic strategy like straddle or strangle, and we'll be seeing like how we take the entry, how we take the SL, how we take the targets.
Perfect. So anyone who wants to go and see how everything works on the algorithmic side, like how an algo system works, Arshit and group will, our team will be making a video about that, and they'll be posting it, so you can follow them. We'll be giving you the link in description. I think that's it for today. So if you guys are liking the content of our channel, please do like, share, and subscribe Optionables. If you find it interesting, do let us know your comments about what type of videos we need to come out with, and any suggestion will be coming up. So thanks a lot for joining in, and see you all next week. Bye-bye.